Hi, Kerry here from My Quick Bookkeeping. One of the things that often bamboozles clients is how to record a deposit that's paid in advance of an invoice or order being filled. In some cases, the deposit is refundable, in others it's not. The example I'm going to work with is where a refundable deposit is paid by a customer, and you want to record it when you receive it, and then deduct it from the invoice when the service is delivered. Be sure to watch to the end of the video, and I'll show you the impact on your financial statements and how to be sure everything is being recorded correctly. We'll be using the QuickBooks sample company. The first thing we need to do is set up an account in the balance sheet where we'll hold the deposits until they can be included in our income. Select Accounting on the left-hand tab and then New in the top right-hand corner. The type of account we're setting up is a liability, because until we deliver the service or carry out something in the agreement, we'd have to return this deposit to the client. As we expect we'll be honoring this agreement within 1 year, it's a current liability. If these terms are confusing to you, pause the video, watch my other video, Understanding Your Balance Sheet. Hopefully that'll explain. If not, please make comments if you have questions, others do too, and I would love to explain further. Detail type is also an other current liability right here. Let's name the account Deposits from Customers. And we can save it. Now that we have an account we can post transactions to, let's set up an item. There's a video explaining this process in more detail. It's called Setting Up Products and Services in QuickBooks Online, just in case this goes a little too quickly. From the cog on the top right-hand corner, select Products and Services, and then New. We will use the type Service. Let's call this Deposits Received. Doesn't really belong in any of the categories, so we're just going to leave that blank. We do sell this to customers, so we'll check that box, and here's where it gets interesting. The only time the customer will see this item on an invoice is when it's deducted from the full amount invoiced. For that reason, I would like the notation to say, less deposit previously paid. This will make sense later on, and there's no set price or rate. So let's save it. Now we have set up a liability account to post the deposits to, so we'll select it here. And here it is, deposits from customers. As you can see, the expectation is that you would record a service item against income. As we've not yet supplied the service and we may have to pay it back, we don't want to be recording income yet. Save and close, and our item is ready to use. I'm going to assume we received a check from our customer. Let's put it in the bank. Pop up here to the cross. When we receive funds that don't relate to an invoice, you can use a sales receipt. So let's just select any customer. We'll go with Cool Cars again. I'm going to deposit it to my savings account. And notice that the description doesn't really make sense here, but this is not something the client will see. So let's put in that we've received $5,000 as our deposit. And we don't want to send this to the customer, so we're just going to save and close. Now let's go and have a look at our balance sheet. We can see the only changes are an increase of $5,000 in our savings account and a liability of $5,000 down here for the deposits received from customers. Now let's prepare an invoice for the customer. We'll say that it's October. And we've completed the contract worth $10,000. Enter the customer. The details of the product or service, let's say it was a design project for $10,000. $10,000. And we're going to mark it as taxable if we have to charge taxes, but for the purpose of this exercise, I'm just going to leave the taxes out of it. Next, we're going to go down to our customer deposit. And here is where we enter the $5,000 that was previously paid. You have a look here, you can see that the deposit notation that we'd written earlier makes complete sense. Make sure we do not mark that one as taxable. Now, here is a little note about the taxes. If we were in a taxable jurisdiction, we would be applying all of the tax to this $10,000 right here. So let's just choose one for the sake of it. So California here, we collect tax on the entire amount, not just on the net amount, because we didn't collect any tax when we collected the deposit. So you can see here that the amount that's taxable is $10,000. Hopefully that doesn't confuse things. So then when we save and send, the customer will receive an invoice for the services rendered for the full amount of tax, and the deposit will have been deducted. Everything looks good. So we can save and send that. And the invoice, the email with the invoice is produced for your review. You have a chance to put some extra words in here if you'd like, edit it, and it hasn't actually gone to the customer until you send and close. Now let's have a look at the balance sheet in October. Our accounts receivable have increased by $5,800. That's the $5,000 remaining on the invoice plus the $800 in tax that we collected. Let's have a look down here further. We now owe $800 for taxes. We've reduced the deposits from customers down to zero, as you can see, a drop of $5,000. And the net income is $10,000, which is the total amount of the services. I hope that has taken some of the confusion and mystery out of recording customer deposits. There are a few steps to get it all set up, but as you may have noticed by now, when everything is properly set up, it's so much easier to get accurate reports, which is even more important when you're billing customers and ensuring that you've collected the correct amounts of sales tax. Nobody wants upset clients, or our tax office people for that matter. We've certainly covered a lot today, so don't hesitate to reach out if you have any questions or would like help getting this set up. If this video was useful, please hit like below and subscribe to my channel for more QuickBooks tips and how-tos. Also, I've created a small business month-end checklist to help you be sure your records are up to date each month so you can make the best decisions for your business. Click the link below to download a free copy. If there's another topic you'd like help with, please make a note in the comments below and my next video could be for you. Thanks, cheers.